When you think of FHM, you think of a magazine that's committed to bringing you the best features in Britain. The good news, we've gone to LA. So, why have we come to LA? Well, it's simple, really. We're in LA to meet Sylvester Stallone.
If I'm going to interview Stallone, I got to get into the best shape of my life.
Come on, fatty. Come on, fatty. Come on, fatty. Oh, give the hammer some fun. Give the hammer some fun. Stallone! 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 Oh.
Well, off that blistering 30-second workout, it looks like I can't turn my Teletubby body into anything else. So, I'm gonna go and have to see the experts.
Hi, I'm Gunnar Peterson, and I'm here to train FHM.
They still got something left in the basement.
Oh, goodness me.
I think I should shut myself.
700 more.
Oh!
You're my best for attack.
I'm Peter. Oh, sick.
Boom.
Really?
Fucking boom.
Jesus. Hey, I'm Danny Musico, and I'm going to train FHM.
What you're looking at is Fi's real-life Mickey. He's got more hair, he's better looking, and he can hit harder.
Practice doesn't make perfect. Only perfect practice makes perfect.
Give me your all.
It's too big.
Stallone, it's in trouble.
And so, after years of waiting, this is finally it. I'm going to meet Sylvester Stallone, the man who holds the Guinness World Record for the most kills on the screen. What will it be like? Well, we'll find out. Skill versus will.
Well, I've got to ask you, back on Rocky IV, didn't your heart stop? You were training with Dolph Lundgren. Something happened to your heart.
What happened is, I had seen the Hagler's Hearns fight, and I thought, here are these two consummate professionals who really hate each other. They just literally threw all their technique out the window, just pounded each other. I thought, you know, Dolph, we've been practicing for months. Why don't you just really try for the first 30 seconds to knock me cold? I mean, I know where you're coming from, but just unload on me.
But he's a two-time expert kickboxing champion.
Oh, my God. Of all the opponents, there's no one even close to his power. So he caught me in under the ribs. I didn't feel it until that night. Next thing you know, I'm on a low altitude flight to intensive care because he had hit my chest so hard that the doctors said, your heart is swelling. They said, were you in a car accident? I said, well, kind of a car accident, a train wreck. I got hit by a big guy. So yeah, that's what happened. So 6 days later, I'm out of intensive care. We go back and continue the fight.
But your muscles also exploded, didn't they? You were training, I think, you were training it and you were bench pressing some ridiculous weight.
Yeah, here, over here on my chest, so I have a lot of veins here. I had finished working out and then the strongest bodybuilder in the world, Franco Colombo, goes, why don't we have a bench press contest? Like, it was ridiculous.
So, the arm nearly fell off?
It did. I have a huge scar here, 160 stitches, where they had to put in a cable and try to attach the muscle to the shoulder. They cut a small, what they call, window in the bone. It was a mess.
Well, I got to ask you about Rocky Balboa. Obviously, at the end, there's a sense that this is it.
Yeah, it is.
Is it not filled with the kind of sadness? I mean, this is a classic character. It's an iconic character. For me, it's the character.
It might fill with sadness.
Yeah.
Very much so.
That's the end.
The last moment, this picture on the steps here, when my hand came down, I realized the movie was over. Ironically, that was the last take in the movie, the last scene. It ended up on the steps in the snow. I said, God, when I bring my hand down, the ride is over. I can't come back to this anymore. And I started to well up. I went, no, turn around. The fact that you end up here against all these odds. So, yeah, it was big time emotion.
I got to ask you, you once said in an interview, and I think, I'm not sure if you were joking, obviously you're Punchy, the dog in this film, and you're Buckus, classic dog in all the other films. You once said, you know, you were so sad when Buckus, who was your real dog, died. You were thinking about getting him stuffed.
You put him on wheels.
Wait, you're serious?
Totally.
Really?
Yeah, just wheels. Like, you know, I said, is it too much? I think I was watching too much of the Addams Family, that, you know, You come home and the dog is rolled to you across the room like, oh, he's still here in one form or another. Then people say, please stop. This is what happens when you have, when actors have too much time on their hands.
Listen, it's been a pleasure meeting you. You're a hero and an icon.
Thank you.
Good luck. Thank you.